Fatima Potacek balances her work schedule as the voice of Dora the Explorer and contributes her time to many organizations such as the Elizabeth Glaser Pediatric AIDS Foundation, the Make-A-Wish Foundation, the Morgan Stanley Children's Hospital, the SAG Foundation's Book Pals, and she was recently appointed ambassador by the U.S. Department of Health and Human Resources, Office of Women's Services, for National Women and Girls HIV/AIDS Awareness Day. From competing in gymnastics at a national level to attending school full-time in an academy for intellectually gifted children to learning Mandarin, Fatima does it all, and she still finds time to participate in the independent projects such as Curfew and the feature film Before I Disappear. Fatima makes the effort to attend, speak, and promote the merits of independent film, and advocate for more inclusion of the genre at film venues, all at the young age of 13. Absolutely, a round of applause. Her continued support towards independent films does not go unnoticed. Ladies and gentlemen, Fatima Potacek.
Okay, so, yeah, wow. I'm really, really nervous. I know that, okay, paper, please work with me. Okay, I know that I may do all these great things, but it's still kind of nerve-wracking to come up here and be in front of all of these amazing people, and I know you guys have amazing accomplishments too, so they really know how to play me up. Okay, so last year, the producers of our film Curfew received an invitation from the organizers of the Vaughan Film Festival for the lead actors, Sean Christensen and I, to participate in a screening of our film and the awards ceremony. Awards ceremony, yes. Not the G word. We had just won the Academy Award for Best Live Action Short, and there were some on the team who felt that since we achieved that pinnacle, we should no longer take part in festivals. But yeah, no, I thought otherwise. I argued that it was really important to use that Oscar win to bring additional attention to the short film genre, demonstrate solidarity with filmmakers, promote the merits of independent film, and support film festivals that highlight shorts and independent films. Well, I came to Vaughan to represent the producers and cast of Curfew, and I enjoyed every single moment here, which is why I'm back. I loved watching Tony and Mark's passion for films spread through an entire community, from the city's elected officials to business leaders, from film aficionados to high school students, and they're all working together to make the Vaughan Film Festival a success and a source of pride for the community. As a New Yorker, a Hollywood actress, and film industry professional, yeah, I know, not a bad resume. No, I'm kidding. Let me tell you that the Vaughan Film Festival is on the radar and will continue to gain attention over the next several years. So I'm very proud to have been here from the beginning. And speaking of proud, let me say that I'm extremely proud of standing up for shorts, independent films, filmmakers, and fellow actors by coming out to festivals like Vaughan. Lastly, I know it was kind of long, I'm proud and humbled to be honored with the very first Vaughan Film Festival Independent Leadership Award. I'm so grateful for everyone who's here. I hope you have an amazing night. Wow, I'm like shaking. This is amazing. I'm only 13 and I'm doing all this amazing stuff, and it's just... So thank you all so much for having me here, and I'm so lucky, and I love all these things, so thank you so much.